Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Isabel Sanford, Richard Dawson,
thank you,
and Betty White. Oh, as we play the star-studded big money match game 7, get ready to match the stars. Marvin Hamlin, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Isabel Sanford, Richard Dawson,
thank you,
and Betty White. Oh, as we play the star-studded big money match game 76. And now here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. What's wrong?
Just turn around.
Yes.
How can you be so chic and have this out? Excuse me.
Where can you get a tie like that for $7.50?
You made me very happy.
Thank you. All right. My dresser will hear about that, this. Are you all quite ready, as I obviously was not? All right. My tie was hanging out. Let's say hello to our champ here, Chip Keys. What are you doing, Chip? Sit down there. If you stand up, your face is in the dark.
That's true.
We want your face in the light here. Chip won a game just as we were finishing up last time. He's got his $100, and now he's going to try for over $5,000, and we're going to see if he collects any part of that right after we see about this message for you. We're ready. Here's Chip Keys. You ready, Chip?
I'm ready.
Here it is, the big board up here. Chip, we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Ta-da-da, blank port. Now, the answer that studio audience gave most often is worth $500 to you, if you match it, of course. Now, if you match that next one, you get $250, and the third one gets you $100. Now, whom do you call on here for a little assist?
Oh, Richard.
Airport.
Airport. There's one.
Betty.
Betty, have you got one?
Carport.
Carport. Carport. All right, there's two.
And Charles.
Where my rich family comes from Westport.
Westport. Westport, Carport, and Airport. Now, do you want one of those?
Oh, I think I'll go with Airport.
Airport is one he wants. I guess they agree with you out there, Chip. We'll find out if Airport is up there, and if so, where. Let's begin down at the bottom, as we usually do, and reveal a $100 response. Seaport. Well, that's... you're on the right track for an airport there. Let's see if the airport is under the $250 response. Newport. I thought that's where you're...
My rich
where my mother and father and governess lived before we moved to Westport.
I see. Last chance for airport. Here's the $500 number. $600. So now, the most important thing now, Chip, is that you got the $500, but that means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now, to collect, you got to match one of the ding-a-lings head-to-head here, and this has to be an exact match.
Yeah.
Time to choose one.
I'll stay with Richard.
Okay. He's going to stay with Richard. You face me, if you would, please, sir. And I will get the $5,000 question here. Now, both of you get your ESP going. Here it is. Dental blank. That's D-E-N-T-A-L. Dental blank. All right, Richard's finished. Now, let's see how his ESP matches yours, if it does indeed. What do you say to that? Dental blank, to match him.
Dental floss?
Dental floss. Okay. He says dental floss will match you, Richard, for $5,000. What do you say to that?
Yeah, I'm sorry. I just had a lot of dental work done, and so I said floss.
$5,600. Chip Keys with $5,600. What's that?
I don't believe it.
Well, you better believe it, because the money will come to you. It takes 2 or 3 years to collect, but you'll get the money eventually.
Oh, wait.
No, it happens in about 2 or 3 weeks. Now, Chip, you ready to play another game?
Yeah.
All right, let's welcome your new competitor now. Here comes Patty Anselmi.
Hello, Patty.
Hi.
Okay, now, Chip, it's stopped. You can climb aboard. I guess you two know each other. And we welcome Patty Anselmi. Excuse me. We ask her to tell us the story of her life.
Well, I'm single, and I'm originally a native of Southern California, and I'm now living in Washington.
In the state of Washington.
Yes.
And you're visiting here, are you?
Yes.
Well, we're happy to have you here in this studio, Patty. Wish you the best of luck. Old Chip here has had a lot of good luck already, and let's start another game and ask you to make your selection. Do you want A or B?
A, please.
A it is. A for Anselmi, she says, I suppose. All right. All the tourists at Mount Rushmore are amazed because right next to the bust of George Washington, they've added the bust of blank.
Right next to the bust of
George Washington, they've added the bust.
Oh, have I got an answer for that?
This is at Mount Rushmore.
I've got right the next best to the answer. Oh, I just love my answer so much.
Are you all right?
That's when they make on the mountain the faces.
That's right, where they carved them right out of Gutzon Borglum, carved them right out of the granite at Mount Rushmore there.
Gutzon
Borglum
was
the name of the architect. He stood up there on that ladder, pounding that rock and mountain. Oh, it was just dreadful through wind.
And there's one of the chips.
That's right. There's that $5,000 souvenir card. Richard autographed it for you. Here we go, Patty. All the tourists at Mount Rushmore are amazed. Right next to the bust of George Washington, they've added the bust of...
Richard Nixon.
Richard Nixon.
I tell you,
Nixon.
That would amaze the heck out of me. So. What do you say,
Marvin?
And then
they put a bag over it.
Now.
Well, I like all those people, you know, with the presidents and all that.
Yes.
But I thought it would be nice to have a little extra, so I thought
Raquel Welch.
Would have been nice.
Oh, that would have been neat. Yes.
Sweet.
That would have been a splendid idea.
That would be something extra.
Yes, indeed it would. Now you, my dear.
I still love my answer in spite of everything. This is a little play on words.
Yes.
And don't get upset, huh?
Don't get upset.
Not them, this person. I said they were going to do a bust of Fanny Flagg.
Or vice versa.
Now, Fanny, don't be hateful.
Here we go, Charles.
And that would be something extra.
Yes, indeed it would. Yeah.
I figured if it didn't work the first time, I might as well try it again. I said something rather sweet.
Yes.
Yule Gibbons.
A bust of Yule Gibbons. Yes. Now, here we come, Isabel. All the tourists at Mount Rushmore are amazed because right next to the bust of George Washington, they added the bust of Richard Nixon, according to Patty. What do you say?
I say...
Raquel Welch. That's...
Raquel Welch.
That's right. You can put that in the slot down there. All
that
right.
Would be it something extra.
Yes.
Yeah, Patty, see, I think the play on words was bust.
Yes.
Do you know what I mean?
Yes.
Have you ever seen Nixon? In the bathing house.
Nothing.
I said Raquel Welch.
Raquel Welch. And what do you say there?
Well, there are those who thought Richard Nixon was a bust. You know, I mean, I said Raquel Welch.
Okay. You stand by, Chip. We've got something for you, but not right now. Right now, we have this for you. Here we go. Now, Chip, it's all yours. Ready? Patty got none on hers. Let's see how you do with yours. The king said, "This is the royal wizard works miracles. With just a few strokes of his magic wand, he made the queen blank."
You're going to have to do that again for me,
sweetheart. See, the king is speaking. He said,
yes.
The king is speaking.
He says, you know, the royal wizard works miracles. With just a few strokes of his magic wand, he made the queen blank. Are there
the
two
king.
Meanings? The king.
The king.
Sing. The royal wizard works miracles. With just a few strokes of his magic wand, he made the queen blank. Did you go beyond the third grade?
Wait a minute.
No, that's right. I was 8 when I left. That's the third grade.
The royal wizard works miracles. With just a few strokes of his magic wand, he made the queen blank.
Honey, I've got the answer. It takes me time, that's all.
Boy,
I went
sure
to a progressive school where they ask you to think it through.
She's over 29, you know.
Really?
Yes, she
that's
is.
That's a lie.
All right, Chip. The king said, the royal wizard works miracles. With just a few strokes of his magic wand, he made the queen...
disappear.
Disappear. Yeah, they got the idea. He gave us one of those answers.
Good news
or bad. That's right. What do you say?
I think it's a heck of a good answer, because I wrote disappear.
Oh, look at that.
And I made a little thing where it was like... What's that? I'm gonna do things where, like, you'll see it in musical notes and everything.
Oh, yeah. Terrific.
Okay?
Yes, yes.
You have something to look forward to. Like,
indeed. Yeah, right. We can hardly wait. Brett?
Let's audition for Marvin later.
Okay.
Maybe he'll write something snappy for our
terrific
act. Well, I thought that there was one definitive answer, and I have it.
Right.
With a few strokes of his magic wand, he made her pregnant.
That's one definitive answer. Disappear and pregnant. We've had the two definitive answers. Charles?
Anyone can be pregnant, but a queen, is, you say it a different way.
It's almost impossible.
You say with air.
With air.
Yeah. Or gas, if you will.
It might have been gas. Who knows? All right, now we come to Miss Isabel here from the Jeffersons. What do you say, honey?
I went completely the other way. A commoner.
Oh, made the queen a commoner. That's very interesting. Very high class answer.
A very good wizard.
Yeah. What do you say, Richard, about the queen and all that?
Well, the correct answer, of course, in English, with child.
With child is the way we say it over there, of course. Yes. That seems to have been the answer, Chip. Now, Miss Betty, do you have the definitive answer or one of them?
One of them. I was looking for disappear, but I couldn't see it. I was so upset about the no blue border on my card that I said pregnant. I do not have a blue border on my card, as everyone else
border
has. You see, everyone
don't
else has a blue border.
Heavens to Betsy.
Okay.
What is this show coming to? Such a high-budget show, too. So at the end of round one, it's 1-0. Patty, round two coming up. We ask you to make a selection.
A, please.
A it is. Here we go. Everybody plays again. The patient said, he said, that eye doctor is weird. I'll tell you how weird he is. He's got the eye chart tattooed on his blank. That's how weird he is. Got the eye chart tattooed on his blank. Very good.
Oh.
Good. All right. Good. Okay. Ready down here? Ever ready over there? Now, Patty Anselmi. The patient said that eye doctor is weird. He's got the eye chart tattooed on his...
forehead.
Forehead. She said he's got a tattooed on his forehead. What do you say, Marvin?
I say stomach.
Stomach. That would be weird, wouldn't it? Yeah, anybody could do it on his forehead, but on the stomach it would be tough. Brett, what do you say?
Tough blankety blank, Marie. I said he had it tattooed on his little chest.
Chest is good. Stomach and chest are good. Charles?
Again, the popular favorite.
Right, indeed.
I was going to say he should have tattooed on the ceiling over his bed. It would be interesting for taking the test, but I said chest.
You said chest.
No.
Patty's looking for forehead. Let's see if we get a forehead out of this bunch down here. Isabel.
I was going to say forehead, but I said chest.
Uh-oh. We're looking for a forehead, Richard.
I don't know. Busts and chests seem to be your undoing, Patty.
Yeah.
Chest, one of those things.
You got to match Betty White to stay in the game, Patty. Betty.
Jean.
Betty.
I have two choices, you see. I go either for the correct answer or the popular answer. In this case, I went for the popular answer.
The chest. All
chest.
Right. That means Chip wins another game. Please stay right there. I'll get back to you in a moment or so, but right now we got to say goodbye to Patty. It was a short meeting, but a very pleasurable one for us, Patty.
Thank you very much. I love it.
And good luck to Patty Anselmi. We've got gifts for you, which will come your way soon.
Thank
Patty
you.
Anselmi, and while she's spinning on, I'll spin this commercial for you. All right. Ready, Chip Keys up here for his second time. Now he's got $5,700. And he's going to try for over 5,000 once again. Are you ready, Chip?
I'm ready.
You feel like a veteran?
Oh, yeah. Well, sure.
He's pretty casual about the whole
thing.
Cool. All right, here we go, Chip. We polled a recent studio audience. Yeah. Chip, man, we got their best response to this. Blank Wish. Now, remember the answer that group gave most often is worth $500, but you've got to match it. And, all right, wake up there. Light up the light and hear your dinger. Do it. Ding, that's right. Ding when I say ding, darn it. If you don't ding when I say ding, then the whole thing goes down the drain. Let's see, and if you match the middle one, you get $250, and the bottom one gets you $100. Now, whom do you call on?
Oh, Richard.
Make a wish.
Make a wish. Marvin? Marvin, what do you say to this?
Death wish.
Death wish.
Betty.
I wish I could get one for you. I wish.
I wish. So those are the three now.
I wash. I get those mixed up.
I wish, make a wish, and death wish. Now think them over. Choose one or give us one of your own. What is your wish?
Well, I thought of make a wish. I think I'll stay with that.
Make a wish. One that Richard gave you. That's what we want, right? We want Make-A-Wish. Let's find out where it is, and if it's up there at all, as a matter of fact. May we see the $100 response? Birthday wish.
Oh, yeah, that's not a bad one, is it?
Ah, you can't do that. It costs us $240.
No, it's public domain, I know.
Is it public domain?
Public domain, don't worry about it.
Not anymore.
Isn't?
No, it isn't.
Uh-oh. Take it away. Uh-oh.
Yeah, we'll just deduct it from your salary.
I just wrote
Marvin.
That. Right.
I didn't recognize that
no,
tune.
Also, no lyrics, so it's all right.
Oh.
All right, let's see.
Happy.
That's enough. Cut it out there. Make a wish. Let's find out if it's under the $250 response. Death wish. There's Marvin's answer. All right. The audience applauded that when he said that. Last chance for make a wish. Here's the $500 number. Go! Congratulations. Boy, Chip, you got $6,200. He now has $6,200. What'd you say?
That's more than I made last year.
It is, really. All right. Well, freelance writing, that's a tough profession, isn't it? But you just keep on. This will give you a little playing around money so you can, you know, just sit at home and bang away at the typewriter. Now, you got the $500, means you're going to play for 10 times that amount now, or $5,000. Now, in order to collect, remember, you got to match one of them. Which one will it be?
Oh, Mr. Dawson. Richard.
Mr. Richard Dawson. Okay, face me again if you would, please. Now we're going to see how your ESP is. It worked last time. Will it work this time? Is there electricity between these two gentlemen? Here it is. Blank policy. P-O-L-I-C-Y. Blank policy. Now, he's finished. Chip, what answer do you want to give us which you think will match his exactly and get you another $5,000? Blank policy.
Well, being from Hartford originally, I'd have to say insurance.
Yeah. There are a lot of big insurance companies in Hartford, aren't there?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, well, we're going to find out right now if the ESP worked for the second time. He says that'll match you for $5,000. Richard.
Take out insurance.
Take out insurance. It is phenomenal. You know what Isabel Sanford just said? She says, you know, for one day's work, that ain't bad. $11,200. How do you feel?
Oh, I feel fantastic.
Attaboy, here comes your new opponent. Let's welcome Farnisha Boswell. Hi. Okay, what does it Scott. Financial, you know Chip?
Yes, I do.
Well, we welcome you. Hello. And ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm a married woman.
You're a married woman.
I have a beautiful little 8-month-old boy.
Yeah?
And I have a 2.5-year-old daughter named Kasmin.
Name what?
Kasmin Janae Boswell.
Kasmin. Isn't
yes.
that an unusual and a very pretty-sounding name?
My husband's a movie buff, and he sort of put him between Yasmin and Jasmine.
I see. Well, that's very original.
Ha-ha.
Okay, we wish you the best of luck. We can't start at this instant. What we have to do is do a little business with America, and then we'll get back to you, too. So you pay attention to this now, if you would, please. And we thank you. Relax. All right, just cool it. Relax completely. Until next time, because we've run out of time. We'll look forward to seeing both of you next time. You were all splendid.
Thank
Is there
you.
Something I can do for any of you before we go? No?
No,
remind
no.
Remind America to watch the Jeffersons.
Oh, remind America to watch the Jeffersons.
Watch the Jeffersons.
All right.
Now you can say goodbye.
I can't say goodbye. Gene Raven here, Match Game 76. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 76. A Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations. Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Connie Stevens, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Raven.
Johnny Olson and friends, thank you for joining us. Can I have a good time? Because I let him out again.
But only for the weekend.
Pleasure to see all of you.
Uh-oh, watch out,
oh, well.
In keeping with the tradition here on Match Game, we got to officially welcome the new kid on the block, Connie Stevens, who's never done this show. So, just do what I tell you to.
You've got to be kidding. Right here in front of everybody?
Yep. A simple.
That's all
fancy.
It's going to be.
Well, oh, that was nice.
Thanks, Gene.
Thank you. Welcome, Connie Stevens. What do you say we welcome Linda Thompson and Don Smedley? Linda's our current champ. She has $8,450, and she's very happy about that, aren't you, Linda?
I am thrilled.
Have you had a chance to think about what you're going to do with that amount of money?
Of course.
What?
I'm going to take my husband and boys to England and Scotland.
Oh, what a lovely idea. That's very kind and generous
Among
of
other
you.
Things.
Among other things. Yeah, you can go a long way with that. And Don Smedley here, we're going to start with you in a moment or so with your second round question. You're doing quite well so far. You had very good luck with your first round question. It's 5-1 in Don's favor. We'll see how this game ends right after we see about this. Hurry back. Now we'll press on here. There's our second round set up. And Don, it's up to you to choose A or B.
A.
A it is, one person plays, and Orson You are that one person.
Charming.
Because you mean I come on your show after months? Just like
that's
that,
right.
And I'm the only...
You're the one.
It's on my show.
You're the one.
Would you mind taking another spritz of the stuff?
All right.
No, it's all right. Please get back. You know I love you just as you are.
Harriet said,
"Yes.
This is the windiest day I ever remember.
Oh.
It's so windy.
Yes.
You're fired.
Yes. All together, yeah. What a hell would it be.
Yeah, that's right. It's so windy that first my umbrella blew inside out, then my blank blew inside out. You're on your own, Orange.
Oh, I certainly am.
Certainly am.
Okay, Don, he's finished. Here it is. Harriet said, this is the windiest day I ever remember. It's so windy that first my umbrella blew inside out, then my blank blew inside out.
Close.
Close. All right.
Oh, don't blow it.
Now, wait a minute. Now, hold on. What answer would please you?
Skirt?
Blouse? You're a randy bunch. What do you say?
I say that if you wanted to hire a fine old team of WASP lawyers...
Yes?
...to defend an unpopular client...
Right.
...Smedley and Bean is whom you would look up in the Boston
That's
Yellow
right.
Pages.
Smedley and
Bean.
And
I also say, unfortunately, Hats.
Hats. All right, so Don,
now,
you did
do
not...
What want? It could have been anything.
He needs a good lawyer, right. Now, Linda, here's what you have to do. You have to match 4 to tie, 5 to win. And everyone except Richard will play.
Oh, okay. No.
I was the best, you see.
That's right. Here it is. Abdul the camel driver said...
Oh, I wish I were playing.
He didn't say that. No, he didn't say, I wish I were playing.
No, I love the Abdul
He
question.
Said, my new camel is giving me a lot of trouble. Yesterday I went for a ride and the camel got a flat blank. All right. Naturally.
Good.
Well, I just love foreign questions.
You like foreign questions? Here we go, Linda. Abdul the camel driver said, my new camel is giving me a lot of trouble. Yesterday I went for a ride, and the camel got a flat blank.
Hump.
Hump it is. Now, let's see. She needs 4.
Get it together.
5 to win, Orson.
I'd like to dedicate my answer to my dear friend Richard Dawson.
Right.
Only partly because he can't play, and partly because he's English. Hump.
There it is. There's 1 for Linda. 5-2 is the score at this moment.
Did you see Fanny's new haircut? She looks just like Little Orphan Annie.
Oh, she does.
It's Little Orphan Annie.
As you know, I have straight hair. I went with Brett to the doctor, and I was sitting there, and they brought out the report on her liver, and it just went...
Straighten it out. What do you say there?
She says arf.
That's 2. 5-3 to score. Arf says Sandy.
At the break, explain what Orson said, because when he wears a suit, I never understand anything he says.
El Humpo, 5-4 the score.
No, I didn't get
it. All right, Connie, the answer that she wants is hump. Yes. What do you say to that?
A lot of people want that answer. Okay.
There it is. Score is 5-5. And now we come to... Well, Fanny,
Mercy, yes.
What's wrong? Are you having a... No,
hot
you're
flash.
Too young for that now, aren't
I'm
you?
Having, I'm no, having a contact isn't. Hot flash.
A contact hot flash.
No,
One more hump will win the game for Linda Thompson. 5-5 is the score now. What do you say?
It's the last hump.
There it is. Linda, there you are, my dear. There's your spot. You know where to go. Don, you're a good game player, and you came very close. It was the final score was 5-6. We congratulate you for a good try, and many gifts will be coming your way from Match Game 77.
Thank
Don
you.
Smedley, while we're spinning him off, we want to send this message to you. Now, Linda Thompson is up here for the third time, and she's going to have a go at the big money. Shall we?
Right.
Linda, not too long ago, we had a bunch of people in this room, and we gave them writing equipment, and we said, write down your... Wait a minute. Hold everything. Well, hey, you dropped in the wrong flat here. Take it out. Get it out. It's hitting the light. All right, pull it up now. Okay. Keep it going. That's going to hit one more time, but it's all right. Pull it up all the way. Get it out of there. Pull it up when I say pull it out. That's it. Thank you very much. And don't let it come down again.
Excuse me. I ordered an orange wall to come in here in about an hour ago. If you see it, let me know.
You just missed it. That's not part of our scenery. No, it isn't. Now, what they want to do is let in the sign. Let in the lighted sign that says all that money on it. You can drop that one in now. And let the right rope go this time. Ready? That's yes. It. Okay, and I'll tell you when to turn it on.
Gene?
What?
I have seen better produced shows at the Kiwanis Club.
Hear that, Mark Breslow?
I'm the director.
Okay. Now, Linda, here we go. We polled the studio audience, and we said, write down your best answer to this. Vitamin blank. Now, the answer they gave most often will get you $500 if you match it. For matching the second most popular answer, $250. For matching the third most popular answer, $100. And three of the six will help you.
Richard.
Vitamin C.
Vitamin C, the popular one.
Brett. Well, there were so many. I think vitamin pill.
Vitamin pill?
It was like A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P.
Vitamin E.
Ooh.
Vitamin E.
Barney Charlie.
Okay, so you have vitamin C, vitamin E, and vitamin pill. Do you want one of those, or have you got a better idea?
I'll take C.
You'll take C. Mm-hmm. You look like you take C. You feel like a very healthy girl, doesn't she? Okay, let's see if we get any vitamin C up there anywhere, and if so, where? May we see the $100 number? E, okay. There is the vitamin that's very good for you. Very, very good for you.
Looks lousy, just one letter on the sign, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Well, doesn't it?
Not I like mean, move on when it looks like that.
That's right, okay.
Not like a nice orange wall.
That's right, not like a nice orange wall. You can hardly find those anymore. Now, may we see the next one, please? Pills. All right, there's Brett's answer. Last chance for vitamin C. Slide it, Ori. There it is.
Very good.
You have a total of $9,050 now. There, get on there a little. There we go. Now, the important thing is you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. Turn it on now. There you go. $5,000. Thank you. That was good. You did that right for a change here, Mark. Okay. Now, in order to collect the $5,000, you got to match one of the loonies exactly.
Richard.
Here we go. Stand there. Face me. This is worth $5,000 to Linda Thompson. We wish you the best of luck. It'll give you a real good bundle if you do it. College blank. College blank. Now, Linda, give us the answer that Richard has written on his card, and we give you $5,000. What do you say to that? College?
Graduate.
College graduate. All right. There seems to be some sentiment for that answer out there. Let's see what answer Richard has. College graduate, she says, will match.
There are many. I said education.
College education.
That was a
degree. College that was a tough one. College degree is another good one. Okay. Linda, you're over $9,000. You're going to meet another player now, so let's all welcome Frank Burt. Here he comes. You know this lady, don't you, Frank? We welcome Frank Burke. We want to find out a little bit about you before we start the game and ask you to tell us anything you care to tell us about Frank Burke.
Well, I was born in Canada, raised in the Middle West,
an over-the-road salesman for 28 years, and I'm unemployed bartender.
You were an on-the-road salesman?
Over-the-road.
Over-the-road salesman.
Same as a traveling salesman.
Same as a traveling salesman. But you don't like to use that phrase? Is that what you're saying?
Not all the time.
Not all the time, yeah. Is it true what they say about...
Sometimes.
All right. Frank, good. You're an unemployed bartender.
Yes.
Well, good luck to you. Maybe somebody out there is listening right now in this area who will give you a job as a bartender. If you're ready, we'll begin by asking you to make a selection of A or B.
B for Burke.
B for Burke. Here it is. Say, did you hear that Bernie the lawyer got disbarred?
No.
Yep. Happened. Indeed it did. It happened after he introduced a surprise witness in the courtroom. Oh. The surprise was that the witness was blank.
Well, let's just do that all over again. Let's start back from scratch.
Bernie the lawyer got disbarred because he introduced a surprise witness in the courtroom. The surprise was that the witness was blank.
Oh, you little green-eyed sweetness, you.
Are you wearing a monocle?
Yeah, I'm actually wearing...
What is that?
A monocle.
A monocle.
Or a cheap piece of jewelry.
You know me. Nothing over $698.
What kind of trial was it?
It was a divorce trial.
No, we didn't. It doesn't say. It was just he introduced a surprise witness in the courtroom, and he got disbarred because the witness was. Well, he's finished. Are you finished, Connie?
Yeah.
Well, we've established she lies.
That's right. She was not finished.
She said yes and then started to write
answer. Holy mackerel.
There you go.
Now, Frank, Bernie the lawyer got disbarred, and it happened after he introduced a surprise witness in the courtroom. The surprise was that the witness was...
Blind.
The witness was blind. All right. I am a little taken aback by that answer because I never expected to hear it. What did you say?
Oh, well, I believe that an unsighted person could be a perfectly good witness.
Yes.
Unless he or she were called upon to give a description of an assailant.
Of the accident, yes.
However, I said drunk.
Drunk. All right. One of the good responses.
In honor of the work that Frank is out of.
And we'll be out, too, because he sure ain't going to get none here with those answers there. What do you say?
Well, I said the witness was dead.
The witness is dead, yeah. Would be very difficult, and that would be a surprise.
Couldn't get an answer.
I said the witness was nude to show the brutal marks on her body afflicted by the defendant, Big Sal.
Big Sal! You got any idea, Frank? Now, Connie, the surprise witness was...
Yeah, well, it would be a surprise. I said dead, too.
Dead? Okay. There's a fly flitting around here. Did you see him?
It's Vincent Price.
No, it isn't.
No, it is. Don't.
Let's catch him. I hate flies. I can't stand flies.
It's here.
Yeah, wait
Hi,
a minute.
Vinny.
Don't.
Vinny, come back.
Yeah, he is. He's
get
coming
him,
back.
Now,
wait a minute.
Don't do that.
Get him.
Good cracker.
All right, Richard, what do you say?
Help me.
No.
What is that?
Was that Vincent? No, he doesn't talk that way.
Okay. I'm a prisoner in Miss Fanny.
I said nude.
Nude! Okay, Frank. One more here.
One more?
You are it.
No, well, she was nude to show her best side.
Now, Frank, you've had your baptism of fire, and we'll continue right after we do a little business with America. Now, here's some of the prizes some of our contestants will receive, and I want you to listen to Johnny Olson. Will you do that?
Hoover, Celebrity 2 for upright effectiveness and the suction power of a canister. Hoover, the number one name in vacuum cleaners. And Hager Slacks, tasteful styling with comfortable fit, machine washable, wide range of colors and patterns. Hager Slacks, because looking good makes you feel good. And the Wherever Electric Super Shooter, like having another pair of hands, make cookies, stuffed pasta, garnish casseroles, and search electrically. And Vividar Pocket Camera, the electronic flash built in for sharper pictures. Even when your subject moves, your pictures are sharp from Vividar. And now, once again, here's Gene Rayburn.
Where? Is he here?
Now,
a bunch of us were sitting around. Well, we don't have time for that. Thank you, Johnny. We do want to get back to the game here. The score at this moment is zip to zip. We're in the middle of round one, and Linda, this is your first round question. Everyone plays. Fred said.
Right.
I just took a flight that was really no frills. The plane just taxis down the runway. The plane just taxis down the runway while the crew runs alongside holding up pictures of blanks.
Oh,
terrific answer. What did you think of that? All right.
Will it bother you if I smoke?
Oh, there were so many wonderful choices.
Oh, well, it's a first-round question, so whatever comes to your mind will be a good answer. And there are many good answers.
While we're waiting, if Tiny Tim, who's a marvelous performer, if you're watching our show, drop me a line, because Mrs. Miller, the Mrs. Miller, wants to get in contact with you. You drop me a Tiny, because I know Tiny.
Yes.
And then I'll pass the information on as to your whereabouts to Mrs. Miller. It saves postage. You know what I'm saying, Tiny?
Okay. All right.
Oh, wait a minute.
I'll contact you, Mrs. Miller, should I hear from Tiny.
Brett, you're changing your answer.
Yes, I changed. Oh, wait, hon.
All right, Linda.
Tiny, I'll contact you in case I hear from Mrs. Miller.
Fred says, I just took a flight that was really no frills. A plane just taxis down the runway while the crew runs alongside holding up pictures of blanks.
Clouds.
Clouds is a good answer. Clouds. Nice answer. There are a lot of good answers here. Show's a good answer.
I don't come on this show often, and when I do, I give the right answer. I ask you to wait to see the dumb thing she wrote. Clouds.
Clouds, there it is. One for Linda. Yeah. What do you say?
What does he mean? I came here to be refreshed, not insulted.
Refreshed?
Take a shower.
I said Greyhound bus ads.
Greyhound bus ads. What do you say, Chuck?
Oh, he wants to be moved to the other tier.
I thought of clouds, but there's something before clouds.
What?
Now, wait a minute, let me think.
Sky.
Sky. All right. Sky. Okay, so we got a sky and one clouds and one Greyhound bus ad, Connie. The crew just runs alongside the plane holding up pictures of...
clouds.
Two for Linda. Richard, show us your cumulonimbus.
Mercy.
Don't forget, Tiny, drop us a note for Miss Miller. Clouds.
Clouds. Hey, Belinda. Tiny, what about stratocumulus?
Yes.
Or a thunderhead?
What? Well, yes.
Now you're talking.
Now you're talking. If Cornell Weil is watching, please call me.
No, come on.
I just love you, honey.
Cornell
Weil.
Love
you in Roadhouse. Clouds.
There it is. Okay. 4-0 to score. Now this message for you. Hurry back here. Join us next time for Fast Game 77. I'm Gene Rayburn. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 77, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Richard Deacon, Fanny Flagg, Charles Nelson Reilly, Mary Wicks, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Bulafont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn!
I have a microphone concealed in my fly swatter. Remember the day we had a fly in here?
I remember the day you killed a fly.
I killed that fly because I hate flies.
Well, we haven't seen Vincent Price since.
They carry diseases and all that. Yeah. So some kind lady saw that show that day. What the heck is her name? Mrs. Klopfer of Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Aww. She needle-pointed this fly. Pete, throw me out a hammer.
I love it.
It is nice.
I think it's pretty. I think the lace is a little much.
Thank you very much, Pete. I should throw it out. You know, we got to pay you $52 because you brought it out. I hope I get... Yeah, you look grand.
Let's put it up.
Yeah, let's get right here.
Come here.
Why don't you use a fly swatter instead of the hammer on the floor?
No, wait a minute.
Wait.
Now, because I'm hanging it here, Richard, does not mean that the flies are attracted more to one area than any other.
They do hang around me.
Yeah,
though.
They do. Yeah. Let's say hello to Terry Harrell and Romaro Skyim. What do you say, Terry?
Not much, Gene.
Now, Terry's the current champ. She's won one game. All she has is $100. And now we're going to meet Romaro Skyim. Is that the way you say your name?
Romaro Skyim.
Oh, Romaro Skyim. Yes. So you're Romaro Skyim.
Uh-huh.
Yes. Where are you from, Romero?
Well, originally from International Falls, Minnesota. Just
Boy, that's
the
a cold
place.
Yeah,
in
that
the
really is. Yeah.
And now I'm living in Manhattan Beach and managing a men's clothing and accessory shop in West Hollywood.
Right. Okay. Mm-hmm. You must be an outdoorsman if you're from International Falls.
Yeah.
You fish and hunt and do all that?
Well, I'd rather go out and just be on the lake than fish. Just laying out there.
Just laying around on the lake. Oh. Okay. Anything you say. Put your hand there, Romaro. All right. Good luck to both of you. We can't start this game right now. Right now, I'm going to do my famous hammer throw at camera 5. Ready? Here we are. All ready to carry on. Ding. Round 1 coming up. Romaro, you may have A or B.
B, please.
B. You've got it. He wants B, and this is it.
You know, I know some actors who can't draw flies, so we're not at all insulted by having the swatter here.
No, of course not.
No. Press on.
Yes, naturally. Paul said, I'm not saying Fred robbed the cradle, but when he got married, his bride walked down the aisle carrying a blank. Paul said, not saying Fred robbed the cradle, but...
Hey, Joyce.
Okay, you got it.
Cute.
Ready.
Are you getting
ready, Chuck?
How do you feel up there?
I feel dizzy.
Romero. Wait a minute. All right, we're waiting for you, Charles. Romero.
Catchy music.
Interesting name.
For a Norwegian,
yeah. It is. Now, Skyim is quite Norwegian, yeah. Isn't it? But not Romero.
Mm-hmm.
How'd you get that?
Well, both my parents have very large families and lots of aunts and uncles and cousins, all with typically Norwegian names, and they found one that wasn't for me.
Oh, I see. Okay. Paul said, I'm not saying Fred robbed the cradle, but when he got married, his bride walked down the aisle carrying a...
Teddy bear.
Teddy bear.
Aww, that's sweet.
The bride carried a teddy bear. Richard?
Well, I would have thought she'd had a bottle.
Bottle, huh? That's really young.
I went to a wedding, they had a bottle. And a couple of bottles.
Yeah. Richard just reminded me that Brett carried a bottle.
Two or three.
A bottle.
Something barred, something blue, and something new.
Right, that's what I did. Something old, something new, something borrowed, something blue.
But a teddy bear?
A rattle, a teething, a nipple, and a pamper.
He covered all possibilities there. What do you say, Mary? His bride walked down the aisle carrying a...
Oh, this kid was so young. A teething ring.
Teething ring. That would be a little younger than a teddy bear.
That
there.
Laughed was awfully short.
Yes.
Rattle.
Oh, rattle is a good one there. Joyce?
I said a bottle.
A bottle. You got bottles and teething rings and all that stuff, but no teddy bears. Teddy bears really aren't that associated
They're
with girls.
They're very in.
Yes.
Oh, it's chic to have one.
At the Olympics, the sprinter from Nerdocrumbesia lost the 100-meter dash because 20 meters from the end, he had to stop for blank. Nerdocrumbesia is our mythical little rotten country.
What does it say?
Yeah, it is difficult.
Where were you when I read it, Charles?
Yeah.
Do it again. Boy, she uses hard yarn, that woman.
Yes, she does. That's well done.
Sprinter from Nerdocrumbesia.
Where is Nerdocrumbesia?
Nerdocrumbesia is our mythical, dumb little country.
It is.
Yeah.
What do the people look like from there?
Well, they're all retardees there.
Do you believe it?
They're just rather sleazy, aren't they?
Yes, they are. Yeah, sleazy people.
I need some pillows if Mrs. Klopfer, who made the fly swatter, isn't busy. She's in Fort Lauderdale.
I do needlepoint. Would you like some pillows?
Yes.
You do your own designing? I'll do them for you.
Really?
Sure.
On the plane? Back
yeah, I fly back and forth.
I'll even buy the yarn.
Good. At the Olympics, a sprinter from Nerdocrumbesia lost the 100-meter dash because 20 meters from the end, he had to stop for blank.
To tinkle.
To tinkle. Hmm. All right. What'd you say, Richard?
I said he had to stop to change oil.
Change oil. Harold, very good.
Oh, go home.
Fanny?
Oh, dear. I said he had to stop for gas.
Gas. Yeah. Okay, Charles?
I have a very trivia thing, but people that watch the show would probably be upset. Richard, several weeks ago, when the fly was here, and today Mary made the announcement that Vincent Price played the fly.
Right.
That's incorrect.
Oh,
David Hedison was the fly.
David Hedison was the fly.
Who's my friend, that's why we got to keep all these things together. Now, that and a dime and
we'll
a lot of gas will get you a beer in Chicago.
Mary?
What was Vincent's connection?
No, I don't want to go on with this anymore now. Stop this.
We can't review films.
I don't know his private life.
20 meters from the end, he had to stop for...
Now, I want the judges to remember what Terry said. She said tinkle. He had to stop for a Nerdocrumbesium rest stop.
That's it. One for Terry. Okay. 20 meters from the end, he had to stop for...
A tinkle.
A tinkle. I'll show you my answer if you'll show me yours.
Oh.
Really?
Yeah.
This is kind of fun.
Well, that place you're talking about sounded as if they might have cannibals there.
Oh.
So
not
I said
necessarily,
he had to stop for a quick bite.
A quick bite. Now, you see, they're not too bright in Nerdocrumbesia, so... 20 meters from the end, he had to stop for directions.
Oh.
See, it's a 100-meter dash.
Yeah, where
it's
are the
a straight
rules
line.
Now?
Well, that's a good answer.
Get out!
Boy, that's awful.
All right, so you picked up two, and there's the end of round one. 2-0 to score. Now we go to round two after we do a little business with you. Here we go to round two. Bing, there it is. Now, Romero, you may have A or B.
B again, please.
B. Gonna stick with that.
B again, and you know darn well that it's B again.
Call us.
Kitsikoo.
You really are full of it today, aren't you?
Turkey.
Oh, is that it?
Well, not really.
Count Dracula said to Judy, I'll tell you why I can't go out with you. You're not blank. Count Dracula said to Judy, I'll tell you why I can't go out with you. You're not blank.
To Judy?
to Judy or Jane or whatever, whoever it was. Who the hell?
I know Judy. I know why he wouldn't want to go out with her.
All right, then change the name just to keep it generalized. Okay. I'll tell you why I can't go out with you. You're not blank. Blank. Blank.
You got a cavity right there.
I have. All right, he's about ready. He said to Judy, I'll tell you why I can't go out with you. You're not blank.
You're not my type.
You're not my type. Now, we may have some arguments here. What do you say?
Well, I hope Romero and I can match. I said type A.
You're not my type A. You said type A. All right. You're open for business.
I'm open for business. Oh, Romeo.
Romero, art thou? Punya.
I'm on the balcony. The right type?
Not my type. Okay, that's two for Romero. What do you say?
I'm not as smart as the others. I said blood curdling.
You're not blood curdling.
Don't you move here.
You can't win them all, Charles.
No, you've been splendid all week. Thank you.
Yes. Just don't come back next week.
So what's happened?
Okay, Mary.
Yes.
I said to Judy, I'll tell you why I can't go out with you. You're not.
You're not, no. You can't have a blood type without being full-blooded.
You're not full-blooded.
Full-blooded. Isn't that rather good?
No, I think it's a very good,
very
interesting
good,
answer.
Very good. Think of it.
Most interesting
You'll
answer.
You'll laugh tomorrow.
Tonight they'll cry. What do you say?
You're not my blood type.
There's the answer. My blood type. Now, Joyce.
She's very smart.
I think it'd be better not to go into that.
All right.
Well, I wasn't really thinking along the same vein.
Oh. Where are the booze now?
No.
There they are.
But this is the sort of the same thing. Breathing.
You're not breathing.
Well, you'd have blood if you were breathing.
Don't explain, because it only gets worse. So here we are in the middle of round two, 3-2 the score. Romero, you crept up a little bit. Terry, you got a match 1 to tie and 2 to win. Salome said.
Oh, I remember her.
That's right. I love your handwork. But you don't play in this one.
But I carried a man's head on a tray.
Salome said Aladdin is really getting nearsighted. Instead of his lamp, he tried to rub my blank. Write an answer just for me, just for the heck of it there.
Let's
Good.
Say...
Yes. Salome said, Aladdin is really getting nearsighted. Instead of my lamp, he tried to rub my blank.
Is that the same as Salome?
Yes.
Salome and yes. Salome. What's the correct?
Salome.
Salome.
Yes.
She had the seven
song.
Veils.
Right.
I know her, yes.
Thin slice Salome.
Remember that?
Yeah. Oh, don't. Stop. You know I can't control it.
What was going on up there?
A lot.
That's a little bit. All right. Here we go, Terry. Salome said Aladdin is really getting nearsighted. Instead of his lamp, he tried to rub my blank.
My boob?
Your what?
My boob?
She makes me very nervous.
It makes you nervous?
Yes.
I said tush.
Oh. Okay. What do you say?
Well...
And there was Salome, it wasn't that bad.
Yes.
Hi. I said tummy.
Tummy. That's one of those things there. What do you say?
I think this could be a match. I don't want to cause a lot of trouble. I said my ironclad bust plates.
My ironclad bust plates. Yeah. Well, the word bust was in there after all. Joyce, we come to you.
Already?
Yes.
I was watching Ira over there. He's like Caesar. He goes thumbs up, thumbs down. Oh, dear. I said try to rub her fanny flag.
Her fanny flag. So guess what? Game ends in a tie, and we'll tell you how we have to break this tie after we tell you about this.
Today's consolation prizes are first, a new generation of fragrances from America's most innovative fragrance house, Man by Javon Aftershave Cologne, Woman by Javon Cologne Concentrate, and a wall clock, and a supply of one wipe dust cloths, a feature dust cloth that can rewash up to 20 times, safe for any service, one wipe, America's favorite. And a popcorn popper, and a supply of Jolly Time, the popcorn with the extraordinary taste the whole family loves, pops tender, crispy, delicious Jolly Time popcorn. And a radio, and a supply of Luden, a good-tasting cough drop, and lots of delicious flavors. You can have great taste, lots of great-tasting taste with Luden. Once again, here's Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Now, here we go. To break the tie, we'll see if we can do that. First, we'll turn off these lights, push the button here, reveal one tie-breaking question for each, and... can we use these, or do you want the ones that went down? The first set went down. Shall I just pull them out? What do you want to do, Ira? This is all right. Sure, they're all of them. Now, one tie-breaking question for each. The one who's matched the most will be the winner. Romero, we'll ask you to make a selection of A or B.
B, please.
B it is. All right. On the battleship, one sailor said to another, I'm worried about the captain. Here we are in the middle of a battle, and he's blanking off the starboard bow. Right!
That was my eyelash.
Oh, I'm sorry. Whoops. Romero. On the battleship, one sailor said to another, I'm worried about the captain. Here we are in the middle of a battle, and he's blanking off the starboard bow.
Throwing up.
Yeah! Throwing up.
Throwing up?
He said barfing.
Oh, how tasteless.
Yes.
I said upchucking.
Naturally. That's tastier.
Mercy. What was Peter Pan's friend's name?
Captain Hook?
Tinkerbell.
Right. Tinklebell.
That's right.
Oh, Tinkling Bell. Right. He's tinkling off the starboard bow.
Well, this goes either way. Well, so did the captain. Oh, no. This is...
Char. You.
This...
You rascal.
Stop it. This might match if you want to be kind. I said doing what he should have been doing in the head off the starboard side.
Oh, all right. That's a match. What? Oh, I beg your pardon. No, that's tinkling. No, that's not it. He said barfing there. Now, Mary, we come to you.
What is it? Speak up.
Speak up. He's looking for the answer, barfing. So far, he has one.
That's
we've
right.
had a lot of tinkling.
I wouldn't worry if the man were barfing off the starboard bow. It shows that he's a good sailor. I said he was fishing.
Fishing. In the middle of the
that
battle.
That would worry me.
That would worry me, too. And you, Richard.
Tinkling.
Tinkling. Now, Joyce.
I like Mary's answer the best.
Yeah, it's a good one.
No, because all the sailors were hungry. I said he was wee-weeing.
Okay. So, Romero, you picked up one. Now, Terry has to match one to tie, and she can win it, however, if she'll match two.
Okay.
The nurse said, you can tell that old man Periwinkle is in his second childhood because instead of a wheelchair, he makes me push him around in a blank. You can tell old man Periwinkle is in his second childhood because instead of a wheelchair, he makes me push him around in a blank. In a blank, right.
Did you know Joyce Bullifant has naturally blonde hair?
Does she really?
I never knew it until
Fred,
I sat up.
Fred sits up there and she says just the opposite. I like it when Fanny's up there.
You do.
You've got no, I miss Fred, but she does say those things.
You are going to play this game, aren't you?
I forgot the question.
Instead of a wheelchair, makes me push him around in a blank. All right. We're going to start without you.
Oh, mercy.
Terry Harrell. The nurse said you can tell that old man Periwinkle had his second childhood because instead of a wheelchair, he makes me push him around in a...
baby carriage.
Baby carriage is a good one. Show us your baby carriage, Richard.
I said baby carriage.
That's a tie score. One more will win the game.
Little wagon.
A little red wagon, Charles.
Baby carriage.
That wins the game. What the rest of you have? Sam, sure. Okay. Come on down, Sam. Now, you go to your spot. We'll say goodbye to Romero Skine. It was a pleasure to have met you, sir. We'll send some gifts your way. Romero Skine, ladies and gentlemen. Let's spin him off and spin a message just for you. Gene Ebner, join next time, Match Game 77. Good. Bye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 77, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.
John, and we have lots of friends here. We have our regular friends, Brett Summers.
Hello,
that sweet lady.
Darling.
How are you? And Charles Nelson Reilly,
hi,
whose work is his life, as he says. And Richard Dawson, what does he always say?
My life is my work.
My life is my work. Now, those are our regulars. And our semi-regulars, people who are here as often as we can get them, are this fellow here. Dick Martin,
hi,
who is 70% of the team of Rowan and Martin.
At least 70.
And this sweet singing, acting type lady, whom we've never had before, we're delighted to welcome this sweet Jody. You're just too sweet.
Smooth.
Jody Donovan. And that lady there, who's here as often as we can get her.
I'll do it for you.
You do it. Thank you very much. Okay. Fanny Flagg, and now let's say hello to our two players, Gene Harrison and Craig Ahrens. Now, we'd like to find out a little bit about each of you. Let's begin with you, Craig. Tell us the story of your life.
Okay, I live in Huntington Beach. I sell real estate. I enjoy tennis, and I ski.
Really? Where do you ski? In this area?
Well, locally right now, but primarily at Mammoth.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good luck to Craig. Now, this is Gene Harrison.
Hi, Gene.
Hello there, Gene. How are you?
Excited.
Are you excited?
Yes. Yeah.
You have an owl pendant there.
Uh-huh.
Is that a good luck omen, a talisman of good luck?
Yeah, my good luck charm is in the audience.
Who is that?
Right on the front row, that good-looking stud there.
Yes, the good-looking stud there. Yeah. I don't see any horses in the audience, do you? You have a friend.
Uh-huh.
In the first row.
Yeah.
Where are you from, Jean?
Originally from England.
Yes, you live here now?
In Altadena.
In Altadena.
And I'm married and got two little girls, Sharon, 12, and Michelle, who's 3. And I think Match Game is the best program on TV, and I think you're kind of cute.
Aren't you sweet? Oh, you're a sweet lady. The one in the gray suit and the striped tie, is that the one?
White shirt and yellow sweater.
Oh, the white shirt and the yellow sweater, that one there, okay.
And two English friends.
And two English friends. Well, they're all rooting for you. May I remind both of you contestants that you're going to be trying to match as many of our celebrities as you can. Now, the winner will go on to play the big money super match, which can pay off over $10,000. Now, Craig, we're going to ask you to make your selection here. Do you want A or B?
I'll take B, please.
B it is. We're off and running. Poor Stanley. As he ran down the block with every dog in town chasing him, he said, "That's the last time I'll go to a costume party dressed as a blank." Did you hear all that, Craig? Poor Stanley, as he ran down the block with every dog in town chasing him, he said, "That's the last time I'll go to a costume party dressed as a blank." You think about that? And they're writing their answers here. Ready? Okay.
I'm ready.
Right. Okay, here we go. Craig. Poor Stanley. Say, aw. Aw, poor Stanley. As he ran down the block with every dog in town chasing me, he said, "That's the last time I'll go to a costume party dressed as a..."
Fire hydrant.
Fire hydrant is a good answer. Now, having heard the audience response, I tremble to think what will happen to the celebrity who does not say fire hydrant. Oh. What do you say?
That was my second choice.
Oh, it was?
Yes. First choice was a little pussy.
Hey! Okay. What do you say? Well, that's one of the logical things. Dogs do chase cats, don't they?
You see my little mouthies?
Yes, I see your mouth. Your mouth is moving and sounds are coming out of it.
No, it's a gape.
It's a gate.
It's a gate.
Here we go.
Because I was so shocked. I was so sure.
Fire hydrant is what he wants.
Well, honey, you fire hydrants don't move. You just kind of go there and lift up your little leg. I said a pussy cat.
Oh, well, that's two of those in a row. Now, Charles?
The litter is getting bigger every second.
Oh, it is. So we have three little pussy cats, Craig Aarons. Let's see what we've got down here. Jody.
Just adding to the mistakes.
Another. There's another one. Four cats so far. Boy, would he have been in clover? He's a cat. What did you say there?
Well, I guess I'm perfect.
Fire hydrant. That's what he said. That's the last time I'll go to a costume party dressed as a fire hydrant, what he said.
I thought first dressed as Doris Day, then I thought better, and then I wrote fire hydrant.
Fire hydrant. That's two for you. Okay. Now, Gene, this one's all yours. Listen carefully. Everyone plays. Steve said... Now, listen to this carefully now. Steve said, "I am never, ever going back to Dr. Smith again."
No. Why not?
Well, you know how when you go to a doctor's office, he said, now, instead of hitting you on the knee with a little rubber hammer, you know the way they do that there, and you go, whatever. He uses a sledgehammer, and he doesn't hit you on the knee. He hits you in the blank. What?
Hits you in the...
In the blank.
In the...
He hits you in the blank. Yes.
Oh, there it is. Now, that's it. Now, you just take my advice. That's
he
the
hits
answer.
You. All right.
Now, that's all right, isn't
you
it?
You brought up something very interesting when you right? asked that question. What is that? Right?
Oh, okay.
Right. Did you finish?
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, okay.
In is better than out.
Right. Right, sure.
Gene?
Yes. Yes, oh, that'll be lovely. Right. All right, Brett.
Look,
we're all set. Now we come to Gene Harrison. I see all lights are going there. Steve said, now listen to him. "I am never going back to Dr. Smith again. Instead of hitting in the knee with a little rubber hammer, he uses a sledgehammer. And he doesn't hit you in the knee. He hits you in the blank."
In the or on the? In the.
Well, it says in the. Does that make a difference?
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Well, we said in the to them, so
okay.
We say
in the
to...
mouth.
In the mouth. Bam. Okay. He hits you in the mouth. Hey, you know, it hadn't occurred to me until you asked, until she asked, that in the and on the really would maybe create two different responses. On the nose or on the head? In the nose, in the head? You wouldn't say that, would you? What would you say, Dick?
I said in the groin.
In the groin, yes. I hesitate to think of the terrible pain. Brett, what do you say?
I say, where do you, are you from the North Country or are you just plain Scotch?
No.
Where are you from?
It's from the North Country.
Yes.
Bolton.
Oh, would I ever disappoint anybody who was from the North Country? You bet your old-fashioned bippy I wouldn't. I stayed in your old Malfi's.
In the Malfi's, so that matches her. That's one for her. Okay. He doesn't hit you in the knee, he hits you
I said in the stomach.
In the stomach, that would hurt too. Okay. Yes, it does make a difference in the and on the, doesn't it, Jody?
Yes, unfortunately.
What did you say?
Embarrassingly so, I said derriere. In the,
that would hurt too much. Oh, I guess with a sledgehammer, that would hurt a lot there.
Bend over. Al Smarto.
Yes.
Son of derriere.
Oh, son of derriere. That's two in a row. You hit him four times there. What do you say? Oh, speaking of, hello, Fanny. He doesn't hit you in the knee, he hits you in the mouth.
I was terribly influenced by in the.
Yes.
And I wrote on the head, I'm sorry.
In the, on the head.
Yeah.
He hits you in the head. So here we are at the end of round one, and the score is 2-1 in favor of Craig. Round two coming up in a moment or so, but right now, pay attention to this. All right, here we go again. End of round one. Round two coming up. Now, Craig Aarons, you're in the lead. We ask you to make a selection. Do you want A or B?
I think I'll take A this time.
A this time. Two people do not play. Richard does not play. Fanny does not play.
That's not true.
Oh, really? Don't tell all. We're on television all over America. Kathy said, my new boyfriend is no fun. Last night we went to a drive-in movie. All he wanted to do was blank. No fun at all. That's right, all he wanted to do was blank. Right, got the idea there. Splendid. All right.
Hello,
we're all set.
Darling.
Craig. Kathy said, my new boyfriend is no fun. Last night, we went to a drive-in movie. All he wanted to do was...
watch the movie.
Watch the movie. All right.
I don't understand that.
What's that?
I don't understand. Isn't that why you go to a drive-in movie?
Well, not when you go with a pretty girl and you're sitting there...
Are you supposed to go with a girl?
Yes.
Well, Dick, that's ridiculous.
Why do we keep doing it, then?
We've been going now for 2 years together. I never could understand why people love drive-in movies.
Yeah, but you've seen a lot of pictures, though, haven't you?
Horrible ones.
Yeah.
Oh, well, we'll go with a girl next
time. I think you're right.
What do you say to that?
I'm afraid that I dated myself, and I said neck.
Really? Oh, it's upside. Your neck is upside down. There it is.
So the story of my life.
Well, now, wait a minute. Oh, I think you misunderstood the question because I'll give it to
you. You can swing that in ragtime, ducks.
We went to a drive-in. You see, he's no fun at all. We went to a drive-in movie. All he wanted to do was neck.
Yes. Well, they didn't like each other, you see.
Oh, I see. Oh, well, that casts a whole new light on it, of course. Yes. You never neck in the movies?
Never. Once in a while we...
Yeah.
Well, hold on. That's another
whole
story, though.
As far as you go. What do you say?
You know what we say.
What?
The man who called it necking was a poor judge of distance.
That's true.
No! Thanks, hon. You know how much I draw on my own personal experience.
That's
with soldiers, sailors, Marines, all that stuff. All he wanted to do was watch the film.
Watch the film. Okay, Craig. Charles, what do you say about this?
I feel terrible. I didn't say watch the film.
What did you say, dear?
Because I didn't have enough money to come up with that kind of cultivated education to say film.
What did you say?
I said watch the movie.
That's what you said. Same thing, another match for Craig. He's up to four. All right, Jody Donovan. Kathy said my new boyfriend is no fun. Last night we went to a drive-in movie. All he wanted to do was...
watch.
Watch? Oh, really? That's as far as you go, eh?
Watching Dick and I.
Watching Dick and Richard, yes. And so that's the end of that, and everybody's responded, and he's up to five, and now we come to Gene Harrison. Now, my dear, you must match four of our celebrities to stay in the game. However, if you match five, you win the game. Mm-hmm. You ready for this? One person does not play, that's Brett. You lay out. The rest of you respond to this, if you would, please. I have here in my very hand a letter to dear Abby.
Abby?
Yes. Dear it me. Reads as follows. Yes.
Abby's marriage is on the rocks. Yes.
Well, you'll see. It'll be signed. You see, you'll understand.
You're not supposed to read other people's mail.
Well, I'm going to read this one.
I'm just killing a little time here. 3 minutes.
Dear Abby.
Well, that would figure if it was to Abby. That's
right.
They wouldn't say dear Fred.
No, it wouldn't say dear Fred, would it?
No.
It says, dear Abby, my husband thinks he's a cow. What should I do? What should I do? Signed, Cow's Wife. Then you see, dear Abby, she wrote back. She said,
Dear
Cow's Wife. That's
right. They do it every time.
She said, dear Cow's Wife, blank him.
Aha!
Oh, no, you idiot! I wish I was playing this.
Give it to him. Okay, Charles, did you put in the slot? You haven't even written yet anything, Charles. Okay, now he's ready. We come over here to Gene Harrison. The letter to, you know, dear Abby is, have you been in this country long enough to pick up a newspaper and see dear Abby's column? You have indeed. All right, the letter says, dear Abby, my husband thinks he's a cow. What should I do? Signed, Cow's Wife. Dear Cow's Wife, she responded, you see. Blank him.
Don't be afraid, dear.
Speak up, my dear. I can't hear you.
Repeat it one more time.
Oh, all right. Repeat it one more time. Dear Abby, my husband thinks he's a cow. What should I do? Signed, Cow's Wife. Dear Cow's Wife, blank him.
Milk him.
Milk him. All right. Now, she said, milk him.
Well, oddly enough, so did I.
Indeed. That's one for Gene Harrison. Score is 5-2 now. Favor of Craig. Brett doesn't play.
I
Charles.
But she's still lovely to look at anyway. I said also milk him.
You said also milk him. The Colonel said milk him. All right, Jody, honey, what did you say?
I also said milk.
You also said that. Score is now 5-4 in favor of Craig. Gene is creeping up on Craig.
If she swung him around a little first,
right,
she'd get half and half. Milk him.
Milk him. Tie score. Now, if she milks him one more time, the game is over and Gene wins. At this moment, it's a tie. Do we break the tie or not?
Hi, hon.
Hello, honey.
I think this is an utter ridiculous question. I said milk.
Milk wins the game. Come on down. Congratulations. Okay. Now, you stand by there for a moment or so. Stand right there on the adhesive tape. Okay. You can look at your public out there. And we're going to say goodbye to Craig Ahrens. We've got some guests, some gifts for you. Together with our thanks for being with us on Match Game PM. So long, Craig. While we're spinning him off, we'll spin this message for you. How do you feel? Okay, here we are. With Gene Harrison, who's won this game. Genie, it's time now for the Big Money Super Match, where you can win over $10,000. Now, to do that, we have two audience matches for you, and whatever you win in these audience matches, you'll have a chance to multiply by 10. We're going to, you know, you did very well with the celebrities. Now we're going to see how your ESP works with a whole big group of people who were here recently. We polled them, and we got their best response to this. Wind blank. Now, that audience, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Now, if you match the answer they gave second most frequently, you get $250. And the third most frequently given response, if you match it, it nets you $100. Three celebrities are permitted to help. Whom do you call on?
Richard.
Wind in the Willows.
Wind in the Willows.
A lovely child's book that no one's obviously ever read.
Yes, Graham Greene, right?
Yeah.
Marvelous book.
And he was English, too.
Fanny.
Fanny. Fanny, Fanny, Fanny.
Windex!
Windex.
No, it's just, is it one word or is it two words?
You want to say Windex? No. That's your answer. That's
Windfall.
No, we have to count your first response. Oh, okay. Windex is what it is. All right.
Brett.
What about windmill?
Windmill. So those are three. You have windmill, Windex, and wind in the willows. Do you want to choose one of those or give us one of your own?
Yeah, I loved Richard's, but I think I like Brett's better.
You go with Brett. All right.
I hope you're right, my
She's
darling.
Apologizing for not choosing
I
yours.
I just want her to win.
All right, we all want her to win. Windmill is what she's looking for.
Oh, I hope.
And let's find out how her ESP works now. We are looking for a windmill. Would you please reveal the $100 response? Wind song.
Oh, that's... I already hate it. They were a funny group, I can tell.
No, that's not a bad answer, wind song. She's looking for windmill. Let's find out if windmill is under the $250 response. Windstorm.
Oh, my Lord. I told you they were
It's very perplexing
a funny
to
group.
Me. We don't have any of the answers that any of our celebrities suggested so far. Oh. Last chance for windmill. Please be under the $500 response. Yes, it is. Okay. All right. Now, Gene, you've won $500, which means that the least you'll be playing for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Now we're going to see how much more you can win with our second audience match. Here we go. Reveal it, Earl. Blank stiff. Remember five, 250, and 100, and now it's time to call on celebrities?
Okay, Richard.
What you are, a lucky stiff.
A lucky stiff. There's one.
Fanny.
Oh, dead stiff.
Dead stiff. Okay.
And I'll try Jody.
Jody, what do you say?
Scared stiff.
Scared stiff. So there they are, scared stiff, dead stiff, and lucky stiff.
Okay, I'll go with Jody's because I'm scared stiff.
All right, scared stiff is what she wants. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. May we see the $100 response? Lucky stiff.
Worth every penny.
That's right, that's the one that Richard gave you. That may be a good omen. Let's see if it's under the $250 response. Frozen stiff.
Oh, uh-oh. It's got to be lucky.
All right, last chance for scared stiff. Here is the $500 response. Scared! Oh, boy! Very good, Gene Harrison. Now, you've won another $500. We multiply that by 10, gives you another $5,000. We add that to the previous $5,000 you won. That gives you a pot of $10,000 to shoot for. Now, to collect that amount of money, you must match one celebrity head-to-head. Which one will it be?
Richard.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. She's going to face me. Now, you're going to concentrate real hard now. Think carefully. Get your ESP going with Richard. Here it is. Blank Hamilton. Blank Hamilton. Now, he's finished. Now you concentrate real hard and think of an answer which you think will match Richard's blank Hamilton.
Oh, it's got to be George Hamilton.
What makes you say that?
Oh, that's the only thing I thought of, Gene.
All right. Well, she says that ESP will work in this case. Richard, she says George Hamilton will match you for $10,000. What do you say?
You're English, and I thought Lord Nelson. Who did he marry?
Oh.
Lady Hamilton. Lady Hamilton. Her middle name was George.
While we're kissing and carrying on here, here is a message of interest for all of you.
Oh, God. I can't believe it. Oh, gee.
Join us next week for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive Brown Fetters, a rotary-powered pickup, a powerful room air conditioner so lightweight you want to take it everywhere you go. And from across the Pacific comes Hawaiian Tropic Natural Tanning Lotions and Oils. Hawaiian Tropic, the scent of coconut, the tan of the autumn. And from Peter Paul, York Peppermint Patties, a cool combination of real chocolate and mint. Bite into a York Peppermint Patty and get the sensation. And to beautify and protect car upholstery and vinyl tops, use Rally Vinyl Care Products from DuPont. And for a smooth-running car, Castrol GTX Motor Oil for all models and sizes of cars, Castrol Lubrication for cars, motorcycles, and snowmobiles. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game TN, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Bernard Shaw said, over on my left, we have the open-air lunatic asylum.
Hello there.
Hello.
Bernard Shaw said that.
He said that. About you, specifically. If you're all ready, we'll have a go at it. Good. By welcoming our two players over here, Patty Olson and Rose Welch.
Thank you.
We welcome both of you. I want to point out that each of you will be playing two games here, and we'll find out a little bit about each of you before we begin. We're a friendly bunch. We want to get acquainted. Rose, what do you want to tell us about you?
Well, I'm married. I have two children and one husband. I just recently moved from the Bay Area to San Diego. I'm in the midst of fixing up our house and everything, so I'm just...
A lot of work, isn't it?
Yes.
All right. I hope it goes well for you, and good luck to you here. Rose, Patty, what about you?
Hi, I'm married, and I have a little girl, 2 and a half, and one due in January, and I love to golf.
Really?
Stand up. Let's see. Don't look it.
One due in January.
Yes, it doesn't show.
Not at all. How do you know?
It's a very small baby.
Wait a minute. Stand up, Brad. She's February. It's February. It's amazing. But
what did I tell you about the open-air lunatic asylum? Was I right? Okay, good luck to both of you. Here we go. We'll ask Rose to make her selection first here about A or B.
B, please.
B it is for Rose Welch. The zookeeper said, Ugly Edna is so ugly. Yeah, you're all right there. Today, when she walked through the zoo, I thought a blank had escaped. I'll help you spell it if you want. But don't say it so loud because people have ears, you know. We're all not...
Okay. Just put that down there.
I don't hear it at all.
I got to learn how to spell it.
Honey, sir, the animals are so so beautiful.
You don't know either, do you? Honey, we don't know how to spell cat. Cat is my answer. C-A-T. Oh, forget it. I'll get an easy
one. That was nothing, Bill, for the love of heaven.
Get the other thing out again.
Try there.
All right, I don't know.
Dear me. Rose, are you ready?
Yes.
We're ready for you. The zookeeper said Ugly Edna is so ugly.
How ugly is she? Out there.
I thought we auditioned you earlier. Ugly Edna, so like today when she walked through the zoo, I thought a blank had escaped.
A gorilla.
A gorilla.
I think this is a match. I said monkey, ape. So ape
monkey,
is a gorilla.
Ape is a gorilla. Yes, match. Indeed. Yeah. Okay, that is. Well. What have you got up there?
Hello, sweetheart.
Hello,
you
darling.
Look very nice. Let me put my glasses up. Oh, it's Chex. It's adorable.
Yes, I love this outfit.
Yes. Yeah.
Thank you, Dayton Anderson.
And the brand is good for your diet.
Very good.
Now, this may look like it says orange and tang, but it doesn't. It
orangutan.
Now, isn't that
that's
a member
gorilla.
Of
that's
the a gorilla.
Gorilla
yeah. Yeah.
Yes, okay. What do you say?
Continuing as will several others after me with misspelling of the word orangutan, I move right on.
You know. Can you spell it? Spell it right now.
Orangutan.
I was right.
Ten.
Okay.
Gotcha.
What do you
darling,
got, Miss Ava, honey?
I am so brilliant, I can't stand it. I said gorilla.
Gorilla. Boy, the rose.
How do you like that? On the nose.
If you can read your writing, I got orangutan.
No way.
Orangutan.
Now, isn't it? That's correct. You know, it stumped me there for a second. It is a word you have to think about before you spell it. But spelling doesn't count here, Fanny. You can draw a picture.
That's for sure, or I wouldn't be here.
That's true. What have you got there?
Well, I wanted to say gorilla, but I may have spelled the name of a social disease. But I think I'm pretty close.
Well, close enough. Well, look at her, Patty.
Boy, that's pretty tough.
Yes, she's got her six already, right off the bat here. Rodney Rich is really rich. Yeah. Who asked you?
Who asked you?
Rodney Rich is the only man in the world who keeps his waterbed filled with blank. That's how rich he is.
I don't know how to spell it, but I know.
Here we go, Patty. Rodney Rich is really rich. He's the only man in the world who keeps his...
Wait a second.
Mr. Wright over here.
Oh.
Is he still right?
Yes. Only man in the world who keeps his waterbed filled with...
Champagne.
Champagne seems like a good answer.
They like it out there?
Champagne.
A bit of the bubbly, my dear.
Oh, yes, of course. Champagne. That's one for Patty.
Certainly. Now, here's two for Patty. Your Dawn Perignon Champagne, a vintage year.
Wonderful.
Certainly.
I was going to make a joke and say something else.
Yeah?
Gas. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You
didn't think...
I didn't say that. Well, just a moment.
That wasn't his answer.
The Christmas party. That was not in my slot. But I know that the object is to match. So
very good. Okay.
Time to get my joke in. Alan Nipsey Russell.
You know, once in Europe I had a bus in it. That's supposed to be there. A bus. Thanks for translating, darling. I had it on a champagne. Very fabulous.
Champagne. Oh yes, of course.
That's
a Hungarian.
Right?
Hungarian spelling.
So cheap. But I can't get over it. How clever I am so far.
Two out of two. It's a new record for you.
Unheard of. I always miss.
Okay, Bill. Speaking of misses.
this is not only spell wrong, but it is wrong. I said Perrier water. I didn't Perrier.
Perrier.
Can you
believe it?
That's
that
would
your
be
mother right there.
Okay.
Thanks, Mom.
Fanny, what do you say there?
Champagne.
Champagne.
Oh, there we
go. Of course, it's a tight game. 6-5 is the score. We'll carry on with you in a moment or so. Right now, we have this for you. Now, since Rose has matched all of the stars, Patty, you have a shot at matching it here. You can have a choice of A or B.
B, please.
B. Okay, here we go. You ready, Bill?
Ready? Oh, I'm ready. Oh, I'm over ready. I've got the answer already. Let me put that in.
I haven't asked you the question yet.
Doorknobs is the one. Oh, yeah.
Doorknobs.
Oh, I was so fast. I ran down there. Sorry.
It's just
too
for
fast.
Your ears.
Okay.
Ralph said,
yeah.
I have a terrible fear of closed spaces because when I was a baby, instead of a crib, my parents kept me in a blank. Hold on, Patty.
Now, you're not going to believe this. He's taking advice from Ava.
All right. Now, Patty.
Got a lot of wrong ones here.
This, you must match him to stay in the game and achieve a tie. That's the best you could do. I have a terrible fear of closed spaces because when I was a baby, instead of a crib, my parents kept me in a...
dresser drawer.
A drawer. Dresser drawer, she said. She needs a match with you desperately to stay in the game and achieve a tie.
Here's some I threw away. She keeps me in the dark. That wasn't very funny.
Right.
So I put keeps me in a drawer. That's very good.
Drawer! Tie game! Okay. Now, when we have a tie like this, we just turn the lights off here, push the button, reveal one tie-breaking question for each of you. The one who scored the most will be the winner. And Rose, you have a choice of A or B.
A, please.
A it is. A was good to you last time. Let's see what it does for you this time. Dumb Dora's really dumb. She thinks the happy hooker is someone who enjoys blanking. That's how dumb she is. Dumb Dora's really dumb. She thinks the happy hooker is someone who enjoys blanking.
I think it would be easier.
Okay. Put that right in the slot there.
I don't like it too much.
That's all right. Okay, Rose, Dumb Dora is really dumb, Rose. She thinks the happy hooker is someone who enjoys blanking.
Fishing?
Fishing. That's one possibility. There are a couple, two or three good chances here. She came up with one of them.
I was going to say crocheting. You know, my ex-wife used to crochet a lot.
Crocheting.
But I said fishing.
Fishing. Oh. Okay, Rose, you got one. Rose is fishing, Brett.
Not me, hon.
No?
I don't believe you know how I feel about sports, baseball,
oh, yeah.
Football,
all
fishing,
that
all that stuff.
Yeah.
There's only one I'm interested in.
What's that?
I can't tell you.
Oh.
Making rugs.
Making rugs. Yeah, you hook a rug, right?
That's a wonderful
it's
answer.
It's a good answer.
Yes. It's a wonderful answer. You hook
it's a
rug.
Good answer, right. Okay.
What we learned at camp, Jane.
What did you learn at camp, Charles?
We had a wonderful woman help us.
Rug making. Certainly
well,
came
don't
in.
Look at my hair when you say that. Right. And Ava Gabor has a wig company, so be careful down there, too.
Okay.
Right.
Is this a wig?
No, don't pull it off.
Oh, all right.
Now, we can go to the Price is Right like that.
I was very stupid on this one.
She thinks the happy hooker is someone who enjoys fishing. What do you say?
Stupidly, I said dancing.
Dancing.
Oh, I know it's wrong.
Now, wait a minute. I don't even understand.
No, do I? I told you it wasn't any good.
Okay, Bill, we'll understand yours, won't we?
Fishing?
Fishing! Hey, you want to do it? That's good.
Thank you.
You got to do. He's getting very
Up for the Perrier water.
So
I got to.
That's right.
To make up for
okay, Miss Fanny, honey.
Sorry, I said making rugs.
Yeah. All right. So, Rose, you picked up two, and now, Patty, you need two to tie again or three to win. Roy Rogers treats his car just like he treats his horses. Today, after his car wouldn't start, he blanked it. Come on, get away from the microphone if you want to ask a question.
Be blank. Careful, they can see your hook isn't fastened, Ava.
Shall I fasten that for you? Oh, it is.
I'm a size 60.
Is Roy Rogers still with us?
Yeah.
He's riding still on this planet Earth.
He likes his horse very much.
He likes his horse.
Trigger is no longer.
Is he the guy that likes his horse? He likes his horse.
Oh, yes.
He loved him.
Right.
He did. I mean, after he died.
Do you want to write an answer, Bill?
They sound like he has a
while we're waiting. Yes, of course. You know who Roy Rogers is, don't you? He treats his car just like he treats his horses. Today, after his car wouldn't start, he blanked it. Hold on just a second. No, now you can go.
He kicked it.
He kicked it. Okay.
Who's moaning in the audience?
Who is moaning in the audience?
I don't know.
One of the producers.
I got an obscene moan call.
Yeah.
I'm gonna...
Got it.
Hey, you know, kicked it.
There's one for Patty.
That was a good one. Okay, he's getting shows, boy. I'm telling you.
I think that's a wonderful answer, don't you?
I do, too,
that's
yeah.
That's a good shot now. We never had that shot. See, I constantly, as a director, have to watch these things.
Do you mind? I'm talking.
What was that shot?
It's a three-shot.
Oh, a three-shot. Yeah, that's a one-shot. Yeah. Now, there's a good shot. Oh, that is a good shot. Yeah. Right. Oh, there's a terrific good shot.
Well, he really knows how to get it.
In fact, I don't really care anymore.
Okay, Brett, show him
the shot of rug making.
Why is Charles wearing dark glasses, or we better not ask? Are we better off not
knowing? He's all right.
Yeah. Sure, he's all right. Yeah. Kick!
That's two for her. Four is now tied.
I hope this is a match. I really do. He sat on the hood and spurred it while Dale made chicken salad sandwiches on the range.
Spurred is the verb. The verb is spurred, and that's a match.
Well, but spurring and kicking a horse are two different things. You can kick a horse without having spurs
that's
on your
boots.
Right. Okay.
Well, it kicked it.
Kick.
Saddle it.
Okay. Now, here's the way it is. Patty, you'll come down here if you would, please. You are the winner. And we're going to say goodbye to Roosevelt only temporarily because you'll be back a little bit later to play your second game right after we play the Super Match with Patty. Okay? See you later, Rose. Right now, we've got a message for you. And hurry back for the Super Match. Here we go with Patty Olson. She's won the game, and now we'll see how much more money she'll win in the Big Money Super Match here. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, Patty, and we said, write down your best answer to this. I think I'm blank. Studio audience is laughing because Patty told us at the beginning of the show in the interview that she's due in January. January. Okay. Anyway, if you match the answer that that studio audience gave us, most often you get $500. For matching their second most popular answer, $250. And for matching the third, $100. Three of our six stars will offer some assistance.
Brett?
I think I'm pregnant.
There's one. You wish.
Bart?
I think I'm in love.
I think I'm in love.
Fanny? And Fanny?
I think I'm sick.
I think I'm sick. All right, the first and third go hand in hand, don't they? I think I'm pregnant, I think I'm in love, and I think I'm sick. You can give us your own answer or choose one of those. What is your pleasure?
I think I'm pregnant.
Let us talk.
Okay. I'll go along with that. If you say so, bring the rabbit in. No, here we go. She says, I think I'm pregnant. Let's go down to the bottom and reveal a $100 number. I think I'm pregnant. You got the right off the bat. It's the low one. It could be up a little higher than that, didn't you?
Yeah.
I think I'm going out of my head.
I think you're going out of my mind. Yeah, that was a song. Let's see if it's up there under the $250 number. I think I'm in love. All right, last one is, what do you say, audience?
Crazy.
Okay, slide it.
I think I'm crazy. Yeah.
Crazy, you're right. What do you think of that? All right, listen, you got $100. Means at least you'll play for us 10 times that amount, or $1,000. However, we want you to spin the wheel and see if you can double your money and play for $2,000. Good luck to you. Give it a hefty spin. Here we go.
Go, baby.
Ding. Let's see if she gets the double. Didn't get a double, but you're playing with a good player, Fanny Flagg, there. For $1,000, face me if you would, please, and good luck to you. This is it. Sunset blank. Sunset blank. Okay, Patty, if you give us the answer that Fanny has on that card, we give you $1,000. What do you say to that?
Sunset Boulevard.
Yeah! Sunset Boulevard. All right. Let's find out from Fanny right now what her answer is. She says Sunset Boulevard will match you for the $1,000.
Do you remember the song Sunset Sunrise?
Yadam, yadam.
I hated that song, so I wrote Boulevard.
Congratulations to you. Now, we want to bring Rose Welch back here. Rose, here comes Rose Welch back to play the second and final game. And you can get up there if you would, please. Now, here we go. Rose, we're going to ask you once again to choose A or B.
A, please.
A it is? All right. The funeral director said the deceased must have owned an Italian restaurant. Instead of flowers, his relatives are dropping blanks into his grave.
Dropping blanks?
The deceased must have owned an Italian restaurant.
Oh, that's sweet.
Isn't it?
Flowers?
Instead of flowers. Okay.
Do you ever have the feeling that he's nodded off when he reads it?
Right.
Very unnerving.
Hi, folks. I'm fine.
Ready, Charles? Here we go. The funeral director said the deceased must have owned an Italian restaurant. Instead of flowers, his relatives are dropping blanks into his grave.
Meatballs?
Meatballs! Yeah. Meatballs, that ain't bad.
Oh, meatballs.
Yeah, anything Italian. Lasagna, anything. What do you got there, Bart?
Close enough for government work, I guess. Yes. I said pepperonis, actually.
Pepperonis. So. Hey, that's another good one. What do you got there?
So hateful with that bloody buzzer. Brrr.
Yeah, it's,
they be a
it's
little
louder and harsher than usual.
Just a zit is all we need. Just and some meatballs and spaghetti with a red sauce.
Meatballs, spaghetti, red sauce. Oh, that's one for her.
What I had earlier today in San Diego at 1 a.m. at Philippi's restaurant on Indio. Meatballs.
Meatballs.
Another free meal.
Okay, but what do you say to this? Instead of flowers, relatives dropping blanks into his grave.
I said spaghetti.
Spaghetti. Ross, you got two so far,
pasta.
Bill.
Pasta. One boo for
pasta.
Me.
Pasta. No, that's Italian. What
meatballs.
Do you got? Meatballs. Okay, that's three. You stand by. Right now, we've got a message for America. Listen, it's time to say goodbye. Say goodbye.
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 Today's consolation prizes are a 16-inch silver-plated shrimp shell dish from Taylor Rental Centers. Taylor rents practically everything. When you want it, rent and save at Taylor. And a Fabergé collection featuring organic shampoo and conditioner, both with pure wheat germ and honey for fresh-smelling hair with Super Shine Super Body Organics by Fabergé. And polyglycol protection for your car. Heat-activated formula that penetrates, protects. Polyglycol won't let Mother Nature rip you off. Available at new car dealers everywhere. And Bissell's new broom picks up dirt and litter, nails and crayons from carpets to bare floors, corner brushes clean to baseboards, Bissell's new broom. And from Hawaiian Tropic comes an attractive beach mat and Hawaiian Tropic natural tanning lotions and oils, Hawaiian Tropic, the tan of the islands. And a grill, an Eskimo pie. Very fresh vanilla ice cream covered with special chocolate flavor coating, Eskimo pie, refreshing, delicious anytime for an old-fuss treat. And from Fesco, the patented no-hands can, the top flips up with the push of a pedal and 6 months supply of lemon-scented liners, all from Fesco. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Chapman production. This program was edited for broadcast.